Police say it is an almost impossible crime to solve, and it is happening more: online credit card theft. Tonight, News 8 has team coverage, including the one thing you need to do to protect yourself. But first, News 8's Dauphin County reporter Portia Johnson explains what's happening.
With a growing population, crime in Lower Paxton Township is driving in at a faster pace. But it's credit card theft online police just can't get a handle on.
I hate to say the word impossible, but it's almost impossible.
Lieutenant Gary Seafelt with Lower Paxton Police says it's almost impossible because it's hard to identify the thieves, and when they do, they find out they're out of state.
Extraditions cost money.
Now, this is not your ordinary theft where someone takes your credit card and buys something online, but police say the thieves are going on the internet to make homemade cards.
If you use Google, you can find sites, and it's funny, a lot of them that you read, they tell you right away that don't do this because that would be illegal, but I'm going to tell you how to.
Lieutenant Seafelt says thieves are purchasing credit card numbers online and then imprinting the information on a card with a magnetic strip. He says in other cases, information is stolen by planting viruses on the computer.
So there's so many ways that these people can get your information and just really destroy your life.
The police department's own secretary also became a victim. Fran McPhillips says she was checking her bank statements at work when she learned her credit card number was used to buy more than $1,000 worth of airline tickets.
I was angry, I was frustrated, because not only am I the victim, I'm also the one who has to do all the footwork. You have to file the police report. You have to file a report with the bank.
McPhillips eventually got all her money back, but the thieves were never caught, creating a seemingly never-ending cycle.
I can almost guarantee that everybody sooner or later will become a victim of this.
In Dauphin County, Portia Johnson, News 8.
Lower Paxton police say they deal with as many as 10 credit card thefts a day. So what can you do to protect yourself and your credit card number? Here's It on Your Side consumer reporter Brian Roach.
The first thing you need to do is keep your security software up to date. Computer scam artists are always working on ways to beat the latest security measures, so if they're up to date, you need to be up to date. Next, when you're using a credit card online, make sure you're using a secure website. Look in the URL or the address line in the upper left-hand corner. You'll see HTTPS. That means this is a secure website. You should also see a yellow padlock. That indicates the site has a security certificate. You'll find that in the upper left-hand corner. Sometimes you'll find it in the lower right-hand side. And finally, educate yourself. Make sure you check your entire credit card statement every month. Folks, I know it's boring and it's tedious, but that's where you'll find any extra charges. And if there are charges on there that are not yours, you have up till 60 days to file a written report with your credit card company disputing those charges. Spending a little time reading your statement could save you a lot of money.